science fiction has the ability to imagine fantastic new technologies that come into place due to the pain points perceived by the author. Fantastically, many of these wild visions come true as humanity slowly comes to terms with the need for these changes. We've seen communicators from Star Trek appearing in the guise of smartphones. Dystopian terrors such as facial recognition software now play a role in our policing and commercial marketing. No matter how many times Arthur C. Clarke tried to warn us about artificial intelligence, we're slowly developing that too. Then there's transport. If you enjoy a little sci-fi in your life, you'll no doubt be acquainted with all the manners of space vessels, as well as more mundane vehicles. How much of this is fanciful image? What are the vehicles of the future in the year 2050? Welcome back to our channel. If you haven't already, make sure to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell so that you get notified every time we upload a new video. Rise of autonomous cars. Self-driving cars have long been a long-standing future prediction. Between 2016 and 2019, the hype started to gather around the creation and perfection of self-driving cars. Sadly, after a string of high-profile accidents and a handful of fatalities, companies such as Lyft and Uber sold their self-driving divisions, having appeared to realize that the AI needed to make these technologies safer was many years away. Still, this doesn't mean that the idea of self-driving cars is finished. With big players such as Tesla, Apple, and Google working on the problem, it can only be a matter of time before we see self-driving cars on the road. Once deemed safe to be trusted by most road users, secondhand self-drive cars will begin to filter down the market. By 2050, the great majority of us may be trusting ourselves to autonomous vehicles. Who knows what the vehicles themselves will look like? Renault recently unveiled a concept with the Renault Float, but given that Back to the Future promised us hoverboards in 2015 and all we got were two-wheeled balance board monstrosities, we suspect this idea might have to wait a lot longer than 2050. Depending on what opportunities appear in the market, it may even prove to be profitable for companies to replace taxis and hire vehicles on demand, having them turn up on the customer's door and reducing the need for individuals to own their own car. Mass transit technologies. If we think the future lies in mass transport rather than individual ownership, you can't do any better than to look at the rail networks. Predictions for 2050 indicate that passenger mobility will rise a whopping 200 to 300%, and freight activity will grow by 15 to 250%. Network operators are already planning their way towards larger capacities and improved speed of between 20% and 60% in many areas across Europe to cope with this predicted demand. Competing against these traditional rail networks will be the new technology, Hyperloop. Hyperloop is the much-hyped idea of Elon Musk, a company founder with the reputation of making the impossible happen. Hyperloops are designed to carry pods that travel through tunnels where most of the air has been sucked out, reducing friction. Alongside this, the pods would glide on air skis, similar to how pucks on an air hockey table float or magnetic levitation would be used. While 2050 is not that far away, and cars and trains will still very much be with us, new technologies such as Hyperloop offer the potential for speeds of 1,200 kilometers per hour, fast enough to travel from London to Scotland if such a tunnel was built in just 30 minutes. Hyperloops are already being built. One of the first Hyperloop in planned operation will be in India. It is expected to go live in 2029. The air and space race. We are soon to be on the cusp of inexpensive renewable energy. The world's first nuclear fusion power plant should come online in 2040 in the UK, with other countries following suit. As electricity becomes plentiful and cheap, there will be little surprise that cars, trains, and even Hyperloops will all be powered by electricity by 2050. Electrical planes may be the next logical step. One of the biggest complaints about the aviation industry is the pollution they produce for the relatively small number of people they move. Now, small electric-powered aircraft are being unveiled. In 2019, a test craft called Alice was shown to the world, capable of carrying 9 passengers up to 650 miles on a single charged battery, the craft can travel at 440 kilometers per hour and should go into service in 2022. By 2050, battery technology will have evolved to the point that a single battery can allow such small crafts to travel much of the globe cheaply and without damaging the environment. Competing against new and traditional aircraft will be a crop of suborbital spacecraft. These have recently been showcased by Virgin Galactic, SpaceX, and Blue Origin, all of whom have successfully launched tourists into orbit. As this technology is improved and the affordability of a ride to space drops to the level that mere mortals can afford it, it may be possible to be launched towards space in a commercial vehicle and drop down on the other side of the planet just 45 minutes later. China plans to begin sending manned missions to Mars in 2033. With following missions from Russia and America all planning to begin manned missions from around 2040. Within a decade of this beginning, expect spaceships to begin evolving to the point where they can transport more than just a handful of astronauts. Instead, they can take whole clusters of families along with the scientists traveling to Mars. Before we know it, business executives and tourists will all be booking space aboard the flights. It might seem far-fetched, but rather than relying on rockets to launch items and people into space, we may be able to use a space elevator. The Japanese company Obayashi announced plans in 2014 that they are working on developing carbon nanotubes long enough to create an elevator that would go into space. The elevator would be tethered to Earth and extend far enough out into space that the forces trying to fling it away from Earth would balance its mass against the gravitational effects of our planet. Scientists agree that this is theoretically possible, but puts the challenge of making it happen into the hands of engineers. If such an elevator was ever created, it would drastically reduce the effort and costs required to place material and crew in space. Obayashi's announcement is that the plan is to have their elevator operational by 2050. What do you think? Are our predictions close, or do you think the next 20 years will take mankind into a strange new world of hover vehicles and teleportation? Maybe we'll dig up older technologies such as blimps and use new modern methods to do so safely and calmly. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on our channel. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.